Welcome back to the Runpreneur vlog, and today we're going to be talking about my favourite running songs and the impact on running, also the impact of music on your running. So the Runpreneur vlog is part of the Runpreneur Challenge, which is our mission to save the lives of children by raising a staggering £1 million for six amazing children's charities, which between them cover the whole spectrum of issues affecting children on a global scale. We're going to do this by embarking upon a crazy running challenge, whereby we're going to run vlog on consecutive days the distance of one lap around the world. Put it in perspective, it's a 12-year challenge of consecutive daily running, at least 5 kilometres whilst vlogging, and I even do it barefoot style. In terms of distance, it is a staggering 40,075 kilometres, just shy of 25,000 miles. To put it in perspective, in number of days, we're looking at about 4,300 consecutive days worth of running. So if you want to find out more about how you can support the challenge, please go to the links in my bios or to the website challenge.runpreneur.co, and let's get started. So, my favourite running songs and the impact of music on running. Well, first and foremost, I think when you listen to music when running, it's important to find songs with a rhythm or a beat which matches what you're trying to achieve. If you have something that's way too fast or too intense, it will speed you up when you don't necessarily want to speed up. If you have something too slow and somber, then it will slow you down when perhaps you want to speed up. So I kind of focus on mood more than the specific song. I do have a few favourite songs that I listen to regularly. I have playlists and playlists and playlists of favourite songs, by the way, and there's all sorts of crazy curveballs thrown in there as well. But what it ultimately comes down to is, more often than not, I will just shuffle my entire music archive when I'm running. Depending on what mood I'm in, depending on whether I want to run slow or when I run quick, I will skip until I find a song that I believe fulfills that purpose. So, the first thing I would say is ask yourself what you're trying to achieve on today's run. Today's run, I'm feeling a little bit lethargic, I'm feeling a bit slow, I'm even feeling a bit out of breath. I've been away for a few days, had quite a lot of drink, quite a lot of rubbish food, so I'm feeling a bit slow and sluggish. So I would not want a really quick beat based song, because that'll push me too hard. I'd probably feel bad for doing it. So I want something nice and chilled, relaxing, where I can get into a nice, slow, steady beat and rhythm, and that will keep me going. So the $1 million question then: if I had to pick my favourite running song, what would it be? It's a bit of an obvious one, and I'm sorry for this, but I've grown up listening to this with my kids and stuff as well. They love it. So for number one for me would be Born to Run by Bruce Springsteen. It's such an obvious one, but it takes me on a bit of an emotional journey when I listen to it. You know, you've got the slower bits, you've got the intense, fast pieces, and it's I have a lot of fond memories with my children, so it always puts a smile on my face and makes me up my game a little bit when running. So I do get a lot of motivation from it. I'm just going past someone, so just bear with me a second. Morning. So yeah, that would have to be my number one. A couple of other kind of curveballs within my running playlist, a couple of current favourites. I would say, if I'm looking for speed and intensity, Omen by The Prodigy is an absolute favourite. Pure and simply, it builds you up and builds you up and builds you up and builds you up. And when you listen to it, you feel like you've got inner strength that you didn't realise you have. So that's really good for really intense, fast paced runs. And then a bit of a curveball, Tunnel of Love by Dire Straits. It's again another storytelling, emotional journey, but it's quite slow and somber for most of it. It's a nice, relaxing pace to run to. It's a really good song, and then it does have a bit of a speed increase at the end. A couple of other ones that springs to mind for rhythm: Wheels by the Foo Fighters. It's brilliant. It's just a really constant rhythm So it's really nice paced rhythm. I find myself listening to that quite frequently when I'm trying to find a comfortable rhythm. And another one, which is an all-time classic, The Chain by Fleetwood Mac. If you've never listened to that song before, that was where the original Formula One soundtrack came from. So it's a really chilled song, lovely song. And then the last kind of 45 seconds of that song is where the old Formula One theme tune comes from. And it's it just turns it on for you when you're running. You just can't not want to run a little bit quicker, a little bit stronger when it cuts into Formula One music. So they are my kind of select few tracks that I love. I do have some really weird stuff in there as well, like Christina Aguilera, Fighter. It's quite good when you're feeling like you're hurting. That keeps you coming through and pushing forward. There's a lot of Alanis Morissette. Again, I shouldn't be admitting to liking all this music, but very deep, emotional, hurting songs that Alanis Morissette sings. It just gives you strength to keep going. So there's quite a lot of songs I'll draw upon depending on how I'm feeling. So hope that helps. So I've explained about the impact of music and how it can impact your running. I've given you my favourite running songs at the moment. They do change. You do get some new ones coming in quite frequently. That's the beauty of it. You can always mix it up. A little hint and tip. I use Apple Music. I have an Apple Watch Series 6, so I have my full, well, I have any song I want on my wrist. But what I do is I have Shazam as well. So whenever there's a song I hear that I like, I Shazam it. It automatically syncs it to a playlist in my Apple Music, which is my Shazam tracks. The benefit of that is that you don't ever have to worry about missing a song. You just Shazam it, automatically goes into your playlist. So when I'm listening to my Shazam tracks, it will produce the songs that I've Shazammed. So that's a cool way of getting new music into your playlist really, really easily. So why should you listen to what I've said today? Well, running's hard. I mean, sometimes, like I say, I just don't feel it. I'm not feeling it today at all. It's a real hard run. I'll feel it, and I'll feel a lot better once this run's finished. But I'm still doing it. I'm 3K in to an 8K run. So, but I feel so good when I finish it. And anything that can help me get to that finish line in a less painful, less drawn out way, then it's beneficial. So I do listen to a lot of audiobooks, podcasts, but music I draw back to consistently when it's a mood thing. Like today, I've been listening to an audiobook. It's been a bit of a struggle because I'm not feeling too well. So I think after this vlog, I'll probably put on some music, some uplifting music to try and keep me motivated. So I won't go for quick stuff, but I'll go for uplifting. So the other thing with if you're using Apple Music or Spotify is you can ask it to play music by mood. So I want motivating music. Maybe motivating might be a bit quick, so I might go for happy music, which is like happy tunes, which will just put a smile on my face and keep me taking that one step in front of the other. So that's pretty much it for me today. Hope that's useful. Any questions, drop me a comment. I'll respond to everyone. Please remember that the Runpreneur vlog is part of the Runpreneur Challenge, which is our mission to save the lives of children by raising £1 million for 6 amazing children's charities, which between them cover the whole spectrum of issues affecting children on a global scale. So I have to run vlog on consecutive days the distance of one lap around the world. I'm on day 436 today of a projected 4,300 and some odd consecutive days of running. So I should, in terms of number of consecutive days, I'm over 10% of the way there, which is a big milestone, but there's a long, long way to go. So if you can support me, it'd be amazing. To find out how, go to the links in my bios or go to the website challenge.runpreneur.co. There's no .co.uk or .com, it's just .co. And Runpreneur is spelled R-U-N-P-R-E-N-E-U-R. Stay positive, stay happy. I'll see you tomorrow.